There's a very painful scene in this week's Torah portion. Rachel, Rachel, gives birth to her second son, and immediately afterwards, she passes away. But before she does, she names that baby boy Ben Oni. And then Yaakov, her husband, the patriarch, Jacob, does something shocking. He changes the name to Binyamin, Benjamin. Shocking because just about every prior time when one of his children were born, 11 sons and a daughter, his wives named them, and he was fine with that. Now, all of a sudden, he has to name this particular baby boy, and in so doing, he has to override his wife's dying request, her last words on earth, naming that baby. I heard a beautiful explanation that'll help us understand what was really going on. Rachel named that baby Ben Oni, literally, son of my sorrow, to send a message to Yaakov. There are no guarantees in life when it comes to your children's spiritual success. Look what happened in your family. You were raised by the greatest parents imaginable, the patriarch and the matriarch, Isaac and Rebekah, Yitzchak and Rivka. You turned out great. But your brother, your twin brother, Esav, grew up to be a monster. You just never know. And now look, I just gave birth to this baby boy. Sure, he'll have you to raise him, but he won't have me. He won't have his mother. He won't have Mama Rachel. His chances of spiritual success, at best, are halved. And Yaakov, right then and there, not after she dies, before she dies, he renames that baby in order to reassure her so that she can die in peace. He tells her, no, this baby's not going to be Ben Oni, the son of your sorrow. This baby's going to be Ben Yamin, Binyamin, the son of my right hand, my right-hand man. I'm going to act as his father and as his mother. I understand the point you're making, and I want to reassure you that although there are no guarantees in life, it won't be for lack of trying on my part. I understand I'm going to have to put in extra effort, working double duty. And so she's able to die in peace after hearing that. So we see from here, don't ever assume you know what's going on when you overhear a conversation between others, particularly a conversation between spouses. And Yaakov, the patriarch, he needed a reminder. He didn't realize he was going to have to do double duty as his wife was about to die after giving birth to a son. And the answer is yes, he did need a reminder, because every guy needs a reminder. We always need to be reminded as to what we're supposed to be doing in the house as fathers, as parents. And if he needed a reminder, the great sage Yaakov, then how much more does each of us fathers need to be reminded that we've got to bring our A game always when it comes to parenting our children. So whether you're fathering or mothering, or whether you're forced into double duty, you've got to encourage your children, support them, build them up, lift them up, and love them like crazy.